Welcome back to Module 2. This is Cindy, and we are talking about getting our QuickBooks started in this particular module. We're all the way down to Section 3, where I want to take just a couple of minutes and go through the My Company option and give you an overview of what it's there for and what it's designed to do. Once you've completed the EasyStep interview, you might see some screens that pop up on top of your home screen. This is your home screen, by the way, and they allow you to put in some vendors, customers, things like that. But I always just X out of those and get back to the home screen so that I can actually start working and enter those things as I go along. What I wanted to do right now with you real quick is talk about this option that you see on the left that says My Company. When I click on My Company, you're going to see that it gives you the information about the company that you had set up in the EasyStep interview. So if you'd set up the fax number and the email and the website, you would see all that here. You can change this information if you need to. You can change it by clicking right up here where it says Edit. It looks like a little pencil, and you can click on that. Here's where if you misspelled the name or you need to change it for any reason, you can feel free to go ahead and set it up there. Notice on the left, you can click Legal Information. If the legal name happens to be different, you can change it here. You can get a company ID, and you can actually put in the federal ID number, the Social Security number if you wanted to. There's report information, and this is where you change the fiscal year and the tax year if you need to. Now, it didn't ask you about the tax year in the EasyStep interview, so here's a great place to do that. The other thing is, there was a question in the EasyStep interview that asked which tax form do you use, and I had told you to choose other or none. Here's where you can change that if you wanted to. You can either choose none from here or pick one of these if that's really what you want to do. And the last one on the left is the payroll tax form information. So you can actually see that you have a place to put in the name of the person who's preparing and signing the payroll tax forms, their title, and their phone number if you need to. I'm going to go ahead and click OK. And also a couple of things just to notice. Here's where the product information is about your QuickBooks in case you need to get to that for some reason. And then notice down here at the bottom, all of these options. These are all sales, just so you'll know. Here's where you can turn payroll on. Payroll is not free. We are going to talk about that in a later module. Intuit can sell you pretty much anything. So here's where if you wanted to sign up for their merchant services account, you could. You can buy checks from them, but you don't have to. You can buy your checks from your bank or wherever you'd prefer. And then there's some other things over here as well. So if you want to investigate any of these, go ahead and click on it and see what they have to offer. I'm going to go ahead and hit the X in the top right. Make sure you don't click the top X. That'll close the whole program there. And now we're back to what we call the home screen. So what I want to do now is we're going to take some time and just go through the home screen and all these options on the left and just kind of see how the QuickBooks window is set up, and that way you'll become a little more familiar with it. So I will see you shortly over in Section 4.
Hi, I'm Molly. Thanks for watching. If you need additional QuickBooks Pro training to help you effectively manage your small business, check out our complete training courses for QuickBooks Pro. Click the Learn More button on the left, and I'll see you next week with additional videos.